Hello, I am Mallikarjun Hudedmani. Would like to share my video lectures and problem solving classes to you all to make your preparation easier and solve problems in a very effective manner. Number of problems which have been used to present to you surely help you to get the good attention to solve the problems. Your constructive feedback is always expected, and please give feedback to improve upon the videos which I'm going to upload. In this single phase AC transformer, it begins with first one, define transformer and mention its application is system. What is transformer? Principle of working of transformer would be other way of asking the question. So it's a very straightforward. You may need to just draw a rough sketch of transformer, define how transformer is a static electric machine which transfer the power from one electric circuit to another. While transferring, it can increase the level of voltage, decrease the level of voltage, keeping the frequency constant, which is composed of two highly inductive coils, magnetically coupled, electrically isolated. It can be a very beautiful explanation for your requirement. So in which the induced EMF in the primary is by self mechanism, induced EMF in the secondary is mutual by mechanism. So depending upon the marks, you can describe it very carefully. So therefore, you have to cut short your definition as per the requirement. Okay. Then we have, you can see here, explain the principle of single phase transformer. This is what is being mentioned here. Having two coils, primary, secondary. Primary, the one to which connected with the supply. Secondary, the one from which supply is taken out. So N1, N2, V1, V2, like this I have mentioned here. This is picked here. So ratio comes here. It's very simple. See, you can see this. How many times this question has repeated in the exam? This is up to 2013 I have taken, 2015 I have taken here. Clippings of some books here. So it has come. So you need to enhance your writing. So many times this question has come means there are quite sure understanding from this question. Then we have the representation of transformer. So how transformer is represented, which is primary, which is secondary, how the input wave comes here, how the output wave comes here, if the turns are same, turns are N2 is greater than N1, N2 is less than N1. So step up, step down, such things we need to take into account. Okay. Then I have how that symbolic representation comes. Then there was a question once asked here, why it will not work for DC? Transformer will not work on DC because this works on induction. For the induction, what happens? Flux must be changing. So we want variable flux. In it is a DC case, when the DC is applied here, this coil become magnetically saturated. There is no change in flux. So change in flux is required. That's the reason DC won't work here for a transformer. If at all DC, you want to make a switch here, on off, continuously, rapid rate, that AC become connect, disconnect, DC become pulsating AC at that time. So that may work there. That's the concept of inverter. DC to AC conversion is called inverter. In inverter, what they do? The battery voltage which is stored in the battery is switched across the terminals of a transformer periodically in a manner so that it gives me a output alternating. So, but in general, directly a transformer will not work for DC. That's what we have to note down. Then parts of a transformer, construction feature. Explain the constructional features of a transformer. How I narrated in the class? I narrated the class in the class as it consists of electrical parts, windings, core, flux, etc. Other mechanical assemblies, tank, then conservator tank, then it is an insulator bushings, then the cooling oil and other mounting jigs and fixture like that I classified. All together have put in a single line here. It require core, it require vertical lines, vertical positions of the represented limb. Yoke is nothing but core of that. Windings, primary, secondary. Conservator is the spare oil holding tank which is mounted on the transformer top. Breather is the silica gel placed in the glass funnel which will provide a breathing effect for the transformer. So usually when the transformer is heated up, the cooling oil evaporates. That oxidation takes place inside the tank. That oxidation will represent
what is the water content inside the tank. That is sensed by breather gel. Gel color is changing. Definitely that goes to replacement of oil like that. So we have safety precaution like overcurrent relay, overload relay, Buchholz relay, which is safety relay with respect to fault detection or any gaseous emission release like this. There's at least few of the things we need to mention. Then classification of transformer would be a question. Core type and shell. You can see here this kind of rectangular frame and windings are put on the limbs of that. Vertical sides are called limbs. Horizontal sides are not used for windings. So therefore, windings can be like this. Windings can be concentric. One tenecoid ring like inner assembly, outer assembly. So you can say bobbin like. So low voltage, high voltage. Low voltage sandwiching can be done like this way. So if we have considerable part of the core is surrounded by the winding, we call it as a core type. And considerable part of the winding is surrounded by core, we call it a shell type. Here I have here. This is shell. Considerable part of the winding is surrounded by core here. You can see here. Core is around that. So definitely we have three limbs. Only on the central limb, we will be having windings. So this is called shell type representation. So we have core type, we have shell type. Let us see how many times this question has come. Compare and contrast core and shell type of transformers. So function is same. Transfer the power from one electric circuit to another. Only the constructional difference exists. And by superiority of their operation, shell type transformers are little superior in their regulation compared to core type. But we know when we have shell type and core type, transmission point of view, distribution point of view, when you divide them, when it is a transmission setup or generation setup, power transformers are used. Shell type, and when it's a distribution type, usually transformers are classified. Some diagrams are being shown to you for your easiness and comparison. Hope I'm audible to you all. Yes, I'm audible.
Yes.
Okay. This can be a 1-4 marks question. Compare, contrast, or bring a comparison between core type, shell type. This way, you can concentrate on this question. Then next important question in this is derive an equation of EMF of a transformer. We all very clearly know 4.44 F(n)(1) is the equation we definitely use. How is that equation of EMF of a transformer comes? So this, you see how many times this question has come. So many times this question has repeated. Clear? So there is a sure that this, if you understand once, the flux wave in a transformer core, 0 to peak and 0 and back to negative peak and 0. So in 1/4 of time, flux change from 0 to 5m. That is the logic used here. You can see change in flux in quarter cycle is 0 to 5m. Time taken for that is 1 by 4f. So ratio of them is induced EMF. d phi by dt is 5m minus 0, 1 by 4f. If I take this ratio properly, 4f 5m. All these things is just a bridging. What is this n1? What is this n2? What is f? What is e1? Everything is just a prerequisite. So prerequisite, if you just take a grant, what is the equation? d phi by dt is change in flux divided by change in time. That's all. This equation, and you just go with the number of form factor, because this is an average voltage. When you have change in flux with a change in time, according to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, it is the average voltage. We are dealing with the AC voltage, average voltage, DC voltage, average and RMS. When I want to confirm form factor, I need to utilize. So when I multiply form factor with this average voltage, I will be getting RMS voltage. So 4F5M into 1.11, it become 4.44F5M like that. Similarly, I need to obtain this. So N1 is the number of conductor in the primary, N1 is involved. N2 is the conductor in secondary, N2 involved. Very simple. What is there in this here? This equation, d5 by dt, 5M divided by 1 by 4F, if you remember. This is for the conductor number 1. Okay. Then this average to RMS shifting by 1.11. If there are N1 conductor in the primary into N1, If there are N2 conductor in the secondary, the same equation into N2. That's the end of your derivation. You did one wave, write this parameter, take this equation, conclude N1, conclude N2 in the equation, E1 equal to what, E2 equal to what. Very simple. This is always repeating what, the 4 to 5 marks question. So no great work here exactly. Then we have different losses in transformer. Just see this black strip. How many times this question has appeared? Least and explained various losses in transformer like that. Copper loss, core loss, like that. In case of copper loss due to primary, I1 square R1. Copper loss due to secondary, I2 square R2. Then core loss when I say loss due to magnetic material involved. That is due to the hysteresis loss due to material, hysteresis nature of the magnetic material. And eddy current loss, the unintended inductions happening in the core. So for that, what you have to do? You have to understand this transformer. The transformer is subjected to function. We assume that primary connects, creates a flux in the core. This flux links with the primary as a self, link with the secondary as a mutual. Why not it itself? Silicon is the conducting material. Flux do link with it itself. There is an induction of EMF in the silicon core also. That we call as unintended induction, eddy currents. So that's what I'm trying to speak here. So eddy current loss is also accounted. So these two, why it is created, how it is accounted, it is by Steinmetz, a scientist called Steinmetz. Empirical formulae is used here. Proportional to flux density 1.6 power, proportional to frequency and volume of the particular material. Eddy current loss is proportional to flux density square, square of the frequency, thickness of the laminates. Thin laminates are formed by the core, square of the thickness is should be used. So we need to highlight loss 1, loss 2, loss 3. Usually this is a 6 marks question, what I have seen. So 2 marks per type, copper loss and core loss 1, core loss 2, like that. So when is that efficiency of the maximum, like that one question will be appearing. So copper loss, just whatever I have mentioned, copper loss I1 square R1, I2 square R2. Then when I summarize them, it can be either primary side or it can be at a secondary side. And also we should know loss is proportional to square of the current. You can see KVA square into I square. Hence it is called variable loss. Copper loss is called variable loss. In these losses, no ampere is appearing here. They are not dependent on current. Hence these are called constant losses. But copper loss is due to current flow. That more the current, more the loss. Lesser the current, lesser the loss. Hence it is called as variable loss in that. The total loss in the machine is iron loss due to hysteresis, due to eddy current, plus the copper loss. That's what we have to mention. So then you may have one important question. Define efficiency of a transformer. Obtain condition for maximum efficiency like that. So any mechanism we have efficiency, ratio of output to the input power. So this has been taken in this derivation. So how this is, I have even mentioned, book to book, this derivation will be different. Somebody may take output by input in terms of output divided by output plus loss. Somebody may make output equal to input minus loss in the numerator itself. Depending upon the type of derivation they have practiced, you have referred, you need to see to it that at the end, efficiency falls such as, so N KVA cos phi, N KVA cos phi plus power loss due to iron plus N square copper loss into 100. I used to use X KVA cos phi, X KVA cos phi plus WI plus X square WCU, which I used to pronounce. Likewise, you need to refer the equation. So therefore, here X or N refers percentage or a fraction of loading. If N is 1, full load equation. N is 0.5, half the full load equation, like that. So efficiency of a certain transformer at any varying load, N stand as loadability. 1 means fully loaded, 0.75 means 75% loaded, like that. So this is very useful in deriving. And another condition is derive the condition for maximum efficiency of transformer. So when is this efficiency is highest? This is highest whenever we have variable loss become equal to fixed loss in the machine. That is a proof here. So we know that this equation, wherever we have derived here, we have derived equation, this efficiency will be maximum d eta by di2. D eta by di2 is taken and equated to zero, maxima and minima theorem. When I equate it to zero and derive, I'll be getting a condition. What is that? Variable loss must be equal to fixed loss. Here it's here. Variable loss equal to fixed loss at that time. So that is the condition we need to prove. Generally, this can be a question, as I have seen, efficiency and condition for maximum efficiency is a joint question all the time. But sometimes it has come separate question in the old schemes. Maybe in old scheme it has come. So condition for max efficiency will arrive along with the efficiency only. If it comes as a separate question, you should have extension like this way. What is that extension? What is the output at max efficiency? KVA supplied at max efficiency is X rated KVA into root of iron loss divided by copper loss, WI by WC into this KVA. So this way, this can be an extension. So these are used in solving the problems. Very basic problems, number of turns, voltage induced, flux, ratio. You can see simple problems, ratio of voltage, E2 by E1 equal to N2 by N1 equal to I1 by I2, transformation ratio, right? Calculation of flux, turns, like this way, clear? So calculation of efficiency at full load, efficiency at half the full load, and output at max efficiency, output at different efficiency ratings has been asked. So many variations, correct? So this requires little understanding of situation. You cannot
Efficiency will ask, sir.
Yeah, surely. I'll come back to you. Load at max efficiency, you're asking, no? Yes, I'll come here. This is the one. KVA supplied at max efficiency, nothing but load at max efficiency. It means what is that output which it will share, it will deliver, being it itself most efficient. That is called as output at max efficiency is same as load at max efficiency. Both are same. KVA supplied, nothing but KVA, suppose 50 KVA transformer, 50 KVA into root of its iron loss divided by copper loss. This constant, when I multiply, that I get a value which is supplied by the transformer, it itself at maximum efficiency. Load at max efficiency is same as output delivered by the transformer being itself most efficient. That means rated KVA into root of its iron loss divided by copper loss. I can show you one example here. Here I have example. Maybe here. Where is that? I think here only. Efficiency maximum. Second primary. 75%. I'll show one problem is there. You can see here KVA for max efficiency. This question, 100 KVA transformer having W copper loss of 1200, iron loss of 960. Calculate the following. Second question, you can see the load KVA at which maximum efficiency occur is asked here. Load at max efficiency or output at max efficiency, nothing but KVA for eta max equal to rated KVA into root of PI by PCU, WI by WC. Hope I am answering your question.
Yes, hope, sir.
Yeah. KVA rating into root of WI by WCU. This is the output it can throw. What is the capacity of that? 100 KVA. So you cannot extract 100 KVA because you are trying to operate the transformer be most efficient. When you want to operate it efficient, like riding a bike at economy mode, it cannot drive whole load. It may run long, correct? No? Same way, you want to carry more load, it may not be economical. Same way, transformer you want to operate at maximum efficiency, it cannot deliver full power. It can be compromised. That is a compromise here. How much? It is running at 89.447 KVA instead of 100. But it is performing you highest. Why? Losses are equated. Iron loss became equal to copper loss. That is why it's becoming highest efficient. At that duration, there is a delivery lesser. If you want to load 100 kVA only. I don't want to compromise the efficiency. This calculation, which your third bit won't be valid for you. You are running it as 100 kVA. Losses copper is different. Losses iron is different. So in that way, load at max efficiency or output at max efficiency is its whole capacity into ratio of root of its iron loss to the copper loss. This will be giving you certain value less than the full load rating. That ensure you machine is performing superior, but at reduced capacity. This is the compromise we need to understand. Hope I justified you. Okay. Yes. So like this, we have